representing the Stingrays, number 52, Robinson, along with 13, Bucois. Number 47, Justin Eli, along with number 11, the quarterback, Brian Davis. Representing the Lightning, that's number 76, Jim Vickers, along with 99, McLean. 20, Jasper Malone. And 4, John Ball. Final logistics being discussed. The coin is in the air. A lot of talking going on in the Lightning. They won the toss over the first of the second half. Gentlemen, the lineup. The Stingrays will get the ball first. Lightning will be kicking off for them. Folks, it's week 4 and a big game today for both teams. Both teams coming off of a win. Ray Rowe. Beautiful day. Get ready to bust some heads. Let's go. Davis is catching a little heat from the Lightning and had to unload a little earlier than planned. The intended receiver, number 30, Jordan. 9:01 left here to go in the first quarter, and it's third down. Third and 11 down for the Stingrays. The ball looks to be marked just at the 43 and three quarters, almost the 44. Douglas, as he cuts back up toward him, he dropped right there at the 50. Missed the tackle is going down. Movement before the snap. Davis getting the signal that the Lightning may have been the first to jump. Dead ball encroachment is called against the Lightning. Good enough for a first down. The chain gave a move. It'll be first and 10 now for the Stingrays. Clock rolls back into motion at an 8:17 stop on the penalty. And the ball is now located at the Lightning 45-yard line. So Davis using a chant that gets him 5 yards.
What's that, Glenn? Oh, man, somebody jump. Somebody jump.
Putting on a run, Robert Brooks, stopped by number 12, Brian Harris.
They missed the jump. Freaking Lightning plowed.
Clock continues to roll at 7:31. The Stingrays have put together a drive and they're on the move. They're all located now at the 35-yard line.
We're in our fourth league of amateur football.
I tell you what,
we get into the summer league, it'll be even, that's about 10 notches above this, that storm, because all those guys play Tennessee State, they all play college football.
Verge's pass is complete from Davis to Verge. Good enough for a first down. It'll be first and 10 Stingrays. Clock continues to roll. Ball now on the 28-yard line. Davis gets a fresh set of four. 6:43 and rolling. Brooks on the run, number 20, stopped by number 70, Gordon Stanford. Second down now for Brian Davis and his Stingrays. 6:15 as the clock continues to move. Ball now located on the 25-yard line. Second and 5 down for the Rays, almost like second and 6.
It's on the video. Just one complaint after the other.
Hey, you can give me a water.
Brooks mobbed in the backfield.
Ty, you got one?
That's no fun. 50. That's Jordan Cantrell, along with number 12, Brian Harris. John. 64, Kenyatta Prescott was there also to add a little flavor to the mugging. 5-14 and rolling. Stingrays go backwards and the ball's now located on the 30-yard line. Third down now, 3rd and 11 for the Rays.
We had about three guys. It ended up being Kenyatta Prescott, number 50. They all mugged him. 30, 12, and 64.
Davis.
Robinson made a big play last weekend, and he's made another one today as Brian Davis connects with him. It's Alex Robinson, vice president of the Tennessee Amateur Football League, and good enough for a first down. 1st and 10 now for the Stingrays. Clock rolls back into motion. And the ball is located on the 13 3/4. 4:31 as the Stingrays continue to munch on the clock and move the ball into Lightning territory deeper and deeper. Davis is the quarterback, Robinson's the center. We're in a row. Whistles blow before the snap. I'll wait for that call. Encroachment, offsides, whichever way you look at it, it gives the Stingrays an additional 5 yards.
Yeah, they drive up, dude.
About 2.5 hour drive.
Yeah. Yes, it's extremely serious.
Why is a big old boy in the red helmet wearing number 6?
I like it.
I mean, that is not a big boy number.
Well, he may be running the ball a little later on. There may be some indications there that we've got him on the ball. He's got it. Let's look at his foot speed.
Play action was sacked.
Play action as Davis goes down, catching the heat from 12 and 76. 12, Harris, 76. Jim Vickers. We'll have to count that one as a sack as the whistle blew. Ball being marked on the 20-yard line, 3:16 as the clock continues to fade in the first quarter.
It's on the 13 3/4.
Prescott comes trotting back in. We ready to roll.
This button here starts his life.
Timeout, Stingrays. They want to talk about it. Head coach Sean Malone. We'll be right back.
Refs do that. Stop the clock.
Second down situation now for the Stingrays. We're back underway. On the reception from Davis, Richardson, Chucky Richardson, number one on the stop, Patterson with the Lightning. Well, now it's 3rd down for Davis and company, 3rd and 9.5, 2:19 and rolling.
Where we at, guys? 10, 11, 12, 13, 12,
so that's about an 8-yard pass.
We're on that's a 10, 11, 12, 13.
Back at the 13 3/4. 3rd and 9.5.
He's going to pass it, though. You don't have to worry. If not, he'll run it. The screen, Russell, Todd Russell.
Davis finds Todd Russell. Touchdown, Stingrays. Touchdown, Todd Russell. Number four now for the Stingrays, and the Stingrays are on the board first. PAT attempt in order. This will be a one untimed down. 1:42. As the Stingrays munch quite a bit of time off the clock. Attempt is no good.
Four completions, 50 yards.
With four completions for 50 yards as Davis took them right down the field for six.
It was a 55-yard drive.
55-yard drive.
Take Tim from 142, please.
Hey, Tim
from 142. 10 minutes from 142.
An 8-minute, 18-second drive for the Stingrays. Back beat for the Lightning, number two. That's Keon Anderson, along with number eight, Marquez Pride. Todd Russell will handle the kicking duties today for the Stingrays. He's done it before in the past. Right wrong. On the stop, and that's where the Lightning will take over. Clock stops, 1:33 left to go in the first quarter, and that's where the Lightning will take over. Goal mark, first and 10, Lightning. Ball looks to be marked at the 37-yard line. First and 10, Lightning. Ball now located on the 35-yard line. 107 and 10 down here in the first quarter. Rays are on the board with six, and looking to add a couple more.
Say to man Rose one more time.
Johnny Alexander on the run, number 84 on the stop. That's Dexter Simmons. Clock continues to Lowell. Davis handed it off for less than a minute. Not quite enough for the first down, about 9 3/4 for Alexander. Ball now located on the 25-yard line.
Danny, did you find the first two game stats?
Yeah.
Okay, then all we got is three or last weekend's. We didn't get those two. Well, I lost them.
Number 3, stopped by 7.
That's the end of the quarter. Alexander was the man on the line, the last play of the first quarter, and Gordon Stanford was on the stop 70. And we've reached the end of the first quarter. We'll pause for 60 seconds and then some. We're going right back to the end of the football game.
Tell them, Big Clark, we ain't going today. They weren't playing the real thing right now.
Go in there and take your frustrations out. Third down now for the Stingrays as we get ready to crank up the second quarter. Here we go. Davis plows forward to get the first down, so he gets a fresh set of four for the Stingrays. Number 2, Anderson on the stop, along with number 12, Brian Harris, who continues to be in on a lot of defensive plays for the Lightning. Clock rolls back into motion now, 48 and rolling, and we're under the no huddle. Anderson, Teon Anderson has picked off Brian Davis's pass, and the ball is turned over, and the Lightning has it now, 1st and 10 Lightning. That lets the Sting out of the Rays as the Lightning takes over.
We got some nice gibberish down here. George has gone down onto the field.
It's like hockey.
It's a little bit different because these guys work on Monday, so you know,
that's really cool.
You know, it's a little bit different. It's our first look at the Lightning, and take out away your quarterback. Here we go.
Galloway keeps it himself. Butchwa, number 13, along with number 47. Justin Eli on the stop. The Lightning picks up a couple of yards on their first running play of the day. Reddix is the center for the Lightning. 2nd and 6 for them right now. Ball now located on the 25-yard line, 8:52 and rolling. Let's see if the Lightning can get something going on. On the stop. Roberts. 3rd down now. 3rd and 4 for the Lightning. Ball's on the 26 3/4. 8:10. Eight on the carry for the Lightning. That's Marquez Pride.
24, did we say 24 was made on the stop?
Pate, 24 on the stop. 4th down now for the Lightning. 4th and just the inches for the first, 7:30 and rolling. Ball now located on the 29 and a half. Big offensive possession now for the Lightning.
There's my relevant, hey. There's my relevant comment.
What was that?
Big possession.
Oh. 21 on the sneak, and that's Galloway. They stop the clock for the change to move, and they give a fresh set of four to the Lightning. 7:04, and they'll crank that clock back up with the first down. Ball on the 31, 31 or 30 and three quarters. First and 10 for the Lightning, and Galloway will work out of that shotgun, and Turner's his lone back. Galloway's pass complete to John Marr. He picks up 6, 2nd and 4. Ball located at the 36 and almost the 37, 36 and three quarters, 6:19 as the clock continues to move. They bring trips to my side. Galloway will work out of the shotgun again. Trips jumped before the ball was hiked. It'll be a dead ball false start on that. Had the right idea. That's the way you do it in arena football. You just take off just as the ball's fixing to snap. And 2nd down now for the Lightning. Clock rolls back into motion. 6 minutes left to go in the first half. I'd like to remind you the concession stand is open. And the video DVDs of all the games for the first 3 weeks are available up here in the press box. Come see me. We're ready to roll. Head. He scrambles back to get it, and he's brought down by number 36, Roberts. And the Lightning takes a devastating loss. Ball now marked on the 19 and three quarters. 5:13 left to go here in the first half. Pass interference, automatic first down. Where the ball is, they get a fresh set of four. Ball will be marked at the 35. We're ready to roll. 4:48. Galloway was operating out of the shotgun, found Rod Ramsey on the run, and they take it deep into Lightning territory. Ball now marked at the 17 and a half, 4:34 left to go here in the first half. Lightning on a roll, and they change the momentum of the game as the clock rolls back into motion. 48-yard pass for Galloway. And Ramsey on the reception.
Is he
has his stats.
That's what I'm telling you, man. It was that quick.
Flag on the play as the Lightning switches to the ground game of number 44, Turner. On the stop, big number 54 for the Rays, Mike Andrews. Face mask is going to be called against the Stingrays. That's not good. So the penalty factor kicking in here for the Lightning. That helps their real estate factor. 25 yards of penalty stack up for the Stingrays as it continues to help the Lightning in their drive. 3:57 left to go in the first half, and the Lightning's all in a row. Galloway up underneath the center. Say on the stop, number 5, clock stops. 8 on the carry, Marquez Pride.
Back in motion.
3:37 as the clock continues to roll back into motion. Ball now located on the 4-yard line, and Tink Alloway has a fresh set of 4. To the Lightning. Galloway hands off to Turner, brought down by number 62, Joe Richardson. Still 2nd and 4 for the Lightning.
You want to score here, Liam, but you want to eat as much as that clock as you can.
Time now called on the field. 2:36 left on the clock for the first half. Our second game will be between the Snakes and the Devils at kickoff slated for 2 o'clock this afternoon. 10:36 in the Raider Row. Turner on the run, 54 was a man to wrap him up and throw him to the ground. That's Andrews. Face mask again called against the Stingrays. Half the distance to the goal. 30 yards and penalties this half for the Stingrays. Still ahead, but the Lightning threatening to score.
Unless he rolls, unless he rolls. Watch him, he's the bad guy.
again on the carry, Jonathan Carter, number 26, along with number 36, Roberts on the stop. Third down, now for the Lightning. And we're so close to the 2 minute mark of the first half.
Okay, 2 yards, third and two. Second and off. I don't think they're intentionally doing this. I think they're hoping to get the third to the end zone. They do need to score.
They hand it off to number 8, and he goes for it. That's Pride, touchdown, Lightning. PAP attempt in order. 1:38 left to go in the first half, and the Lightning is on the board. They'll try to add to that with a PAT attempt. Marr to hold, Hartman to kick. We'll see what happens. Hartman's kick goes through the double bars. He picks himself up 1 point. So your score with 1:38 left to go in the first half. Lightning creeps on top, 7-6. On the kick, back deep for the Stingrays, Larry Burns along with Douglas. Turn, Cadle, 6 on the stop. Dominique Watkins, that's where the Stingrays will take over. 1st and 10 Stingrays with 1:31 left to go here in the first half. Ball located on the 34-yard line of the Stingrays. So the clock will start. We'll see what the Stingrays can do with 1:26 and counting. Pass is complete to number 30. Jordan, 1 on the stop. Patterson, good enough for a first down. Davis catches a fresh set of 4. Ball moves to the 45. 11-yard pass, and clock rolls into motion. Clock stops as Patterson creeps into the backfield. It looks right into Davis's bars. Offsides is called against the Lightning. That puts the ball on the 50. That's 20 yards of penalties against the Lightning. Still first down, 1st and 5. Clock rolls back into motion. 1:02.
Yes, he does. Yes, yeah, you. When he's wet, that's the reason. I mean, that's the and it doesn't matter what you think, whatever he thinks, he's running the game.
Davis continues to use Georgie as a target. Brought down by number three of the Lightning, Jerome Jones, and the clock stops with 27 ticks left to go in the first half. Rays threatening to score as they move the ball effectively downfield.
Timeout
has been called on the field. The ball is located on the 17. Gives the signal for that timeout to wrap up. We'll see what happens. Stingray's got 27 seconds. They're going to try to score. The Lightning's going to do their best to stop them. Russell on the run. The clock stops. He really didn't want to go down. He's tripped up by number 50. Cantrell, Jordan Cantrell. Second down on a timeout. Second and two. But more importantly, there's 18 ticks left to go in the first half. Please stop by the concession stand. And 18 seconds left. Ball located at the 8. Clock continues to roll.
Stop it, stop it.
What do you want? You want 7? 8? We put 8 seconds. Hold up, guys. We'll get it right. We're watching both guys. Clock rolls. Okay, Davis stops it with 5 ticks left.
We did exactly what they told us. The guy on the far side has that call when the ball goes over there. So he said kept rolling, so we kept rolling. And he's the one that's got that call.
Timeout Lightning.
I think the players themselves, that's why. what I say earlier about that bomb?
What a thought. Yeah, baby!
Doug gives the signal for the timeout to wrap up. Davis finds Douglas in the end zone, good enough for six. Touchdown, Douglas, touchdown. Stingrays. Touchdown pass thrown by Davis for the day. Rays are on top. PAT attempt in order. Once we do this, we'll go to the half, guys. Flag before the snap. Dead ball false start called against Stingrays. Back it up, five. The substitution is called against the Stingrays. That'll back it up an additional five. Davis finds third, good enough for 2 points. And that'll wrap it up for the first half. Your score, Stingrays 14, Lightning 7. Off of the Stingrays. Anderson and Pride are back deep for the Lightning. Let's go. 20 minutes is in the book, 20 to go. Ladies and gentlemen, Tennessee Amateur Football League coming at you. Lightning, they mark it at the 50. 9 seconds tick off the clock
and that's where the Lightning will go to work in the direction of Tay Galloway. Clock rolls into motion. First and 10, Lightning.
I just had to have something to eat. I don't care to play.
Galloway. Galloway.
Come on. He's coming.
Galloway keeps it himself and brings it to this side of the field. Number 24 on the stop. That's Corey Pate. Team was also there. Clark. Keith Clark. Not quite enough for the first down. 42 and three quarters is where the ball rides. About a 7 1/4 grade. Galloway's pass is complete to Anderson, and the Lightning's on a roll. It'll be first and 10, Lightning. Yard pass and catch from Galloway to Anderson, and they split them both ways. Just as Galloway gave it to Pride, Craig Dunn tossed the flag forward. Dead ball, false start. Could have been illegal formation. Not really for sure. Either way, it's 5 yards against the Lightning. 8:44 left to go in the third. Not enough men on the line, so it was an illegal formation called as Dunn caught that. Ball on the 16 and a half. Galloway's head. All the receivers faded to his side. He tried to dump it. Incomplete pass.
I think he was on the opposite side.
But really, he had time. I mean, he was on the road, but he had time, and he had receivers. I don't know if they were open.
Yeah, but they were covered like blankets
by about three of them. Were they covered like syrup on pancakes?
Hey, here he comes.
Because it's, yeah. He's the first person touching this ball.
Galloway was catching. He is the ball went again over his head. He brought it to this side of the field. Found John Marr in the end zone and drilled him. Touchdown Lightning. Touchdown Marr. PAT attempt in order.
8-6.
So your score is 14-13. Rays are on top, so a crucial PAT attempt now for the Lightning. Marr is your holder. Hardeman is the kicker. Let's see what happens.
Been known to fake and see Mark and throw.
Good.
Hardeman's kick goes through the uprights and good enough for 1 point. Ladies and gentlemen, with 8:10 left to go in the third quarter, we're tied at 14. Yard drive after Anderson returned it in good position to take Galloway, and the Lightning took over and took it to the end zone.
Let's go,
back deep for the Stingrays, number 6 Larry Burge along with 1 Douglas. Hardeman will put it in the air. Ready to buckle him up.
Sure has. I knew it was. This week 4, I mean, that first week it was kind of sketchy. I think Danny was a little concerned what he got himself into. I mean, it was just terrible.
Number 1.
Douglas brings it to this side of the field and picks up a couple, 79 on the stop shot of Trevor.
Guys, he was trying to read his blocks. You know, slow down right now, but you got to go and know about the ball formations design.
Here we go, ball on the 26th and 3/4, and that's where the Stingrays go to work. Clock rolls into motion, 7:53, left to go in the third. Robinson's the center. Brian Davis is the quarterback. Back underway.
Two-play,
73-yard drive. All Russell, all Alexander. for the Steak Race by D for the Lightning. Anderson
and Pride.
Oh, killed him. Let's take it to 20.
Take Galloway's quarterback, credits to the center. We're ready to go.
Anderson.
Anderson catches Galloway's pass, brought down by number 24, Corey Pate. Clock continues to roll as the ball stays inbound. 6:13. We're left to go in the third. Ball creeps almost on to the 25-yard line. 5-yard pickup for the Lightning. Second and 5. Third down, 5:40 left to go in the third. Clock stops. Galloway foot tackle by number 36, Jamel Roberts. Lost 4 yards. That'll make it 4th and 9. Hardeman will go back deep to put the ball in the air. Back deep for the Stingrays to catch this puck. Douglas. Number 12 puts his foot on it. That's Brian Harris. Pass complete to 6. Larry Burns brought down by number 31, McKinney. I'd like to wish a happy birthday, Jordan Campbell, McLean's son. Clock rolls back into motion. 1st and 10 now for the Stingrays. The ball lies slightly into Lightning territory, just on the 49 and a half.
Wake up. Wake up.
Brooks on the carry, number 20, number 6 on the stop, Dominique Lykins. Dominique Lykins, who formerly wore number 68, sporting number 6. 3:30 left to go here in the third quarter. Ball now back across into Stingray territory, just at the 49 and 3 quarters. Here we go. Davis's pass complete to number 88. Chucky Richardson. Stopped by number 12, Harris. First and 10 now for the Stingrays as the ball moves into Lightning territory. Ball located on the 39 and a quarter. 2:55 left to go in the third. They'll step it off from the line of scrimmage. Ball now on the 49 and a quarter. It'll be a good 19 yards. First and 19 now for Stingrays. 2:30 left to go in the third. Jones. Second 19 now for the Stingrays.
So they bring Russell in and they kick 22 out. McGowan. Teron McGowan.
Brooks takes it to the far side of the field. He's chased out of bounds by number 31 of the Lightning. McKinney, see what the flag prevails.
Is that holding on them?
Oh, call against the Lightning, and that's good enough for a first down. They'll stop it off.
Hey!
located at the 20. Fresh set of four for Brian Davis. 1:57 clock rolls into motion.
Successful in this running play. I tell everybody to block, man. Just give him the book, see if he can't score. Everybody else has. But that's what they do to Brooks.
Little mishandled handoff tended for Brooks. Catching heat from the Lightning quickly. -5 on that, 1:15. Clock continues to roll, it was a running play. Either way, 1:18. Ball on the 26. Harris on the stop, number 12, number 33, Jimmy Hill on the reception.
Jimmy Hill.
Less than 30 seconds left to go in the third.
Sonny started at shortstop last night for the varsity.
And we're going to let this one come to an end. 6 seconds is all that remains. Guys, we'll grab some water and we'll get ready to roll. Jonathan Carter, number 26, touchdown. Carter, touchdown. PAT attempt in order. This will be one untying down. Now for the Stingrays. Give it to 26, Carter, number 50, was there on the stop. First man laying the initial contract is Cantrell. So 9:35 left to go in the ballgame. Your score, Stingrays 28, Lightning 14.
off of the Stingrays back deep. Anderson along with Pride, the Lightning. 9:35 left to go in the contest. Let's see what happens. Verge. That's where the Lightning will take over. First and 10, Lightning. 9:27 left to go in the ball game, and the Lightning is going to have to strike fast. Ball will be located at the 37-yard line, and that's where the Lightning will go to work under the direction of Galloway. Number 21, Reddits is the center, and number 75. Let's see what we got. Incomplete pass, the shoulders of Waugh collide. Clock stops with 8:56 left to go in the ball game. Galloway's pass complete to Pride. Number 36 over Scott. That's Roberts, Jamel Roberts. Third down now for the Lightning. 8:27 left to go in the ball game.
This team in the Burgundy's from Alabama. It's got 21
Galloway's two-step drop pass incomplete. Clock stops, 8:08 left to go to the ball game. Third down now for the Lightning. Stop by number one, Patterson. Third down, and the ball's on the 9-yard line. Third and four.
Tires.
Hill on the run, taken down by Dominique Watkins, number six. Hill continued to pick up yards. Ball on the four, first and goal from the Stingrays.
Somebody on that red team get hurt?
Clock stops.
DB played for the Falcons, Brian Harris.
Flag waved off, so we'll start the clock and roll. First and goal.
Just 9 men, Max. Play a game.
Rays take a little too much time to catch a delay of game. That'll back it up 5. They'll repeat their first down. Clock rolls back into motion. Ball on the 8.5. Hill on the run again, number 33, number 50 on the stop, Jordan Cantrell.
Stop the clock.
Timeout Lightning, it's a second down, second about 3. Lightning, want to talk about it? Touchdown, Jimmy Hill, number 33. Touchdown, Stingrays. PAT attempt in order. 2:36 left to go in the ball game. This will be one untimed down. Hill, he's stopped by Patterson and Jones. The PAT attempt is no good. So 2:36 left to go in the ball game. Your score, Stingrays 34, Lightning 14.
Yeah.
passing back heat for the Lightning along with Pride. Number 10, Keith Clark will put the ball in the air for the Stingrays. Turn 82 on the stop. Lance Edwards, along with number 27, Nash Via. It'll be first and 10, Lightning. Ball marked on the 36. The clock rolls into motion. Galloway is the quarterback. Reddix is the center. Completed to number 24, clock will stop as they get reset. That's Ramsey, his second long reception of the day. Timeout Lightning with 1:27 left to go in the ballgame. Completion for the Lightning Railroad.
I'm going to get into the ball again. That's the Eagle Bowl.
Eagle Bowl.
Marr and Jones were the intended receivers. Pate, there on the defense, along with number 26, Carter. Anderson was the intended receiver. Indication pass interference is called against the Stingrays as he got bugged on the far side of the end zone. It'll be an automatic first down. We'll wait for the final spot. Just inside the 5-yard line. A take out away gets a fresh set of four. 1:17 left to go in the ball game.
How many yards was that field? Okay, just a second.
Pass incomplete.
The only way to get there is we got to get on the field. And right there, you see that gate there where those two little girls are? You go through there, and then you can walk. Well, the game's over here. Don't walk over here. Don't come on your field. So you can just wait. Right after the game, you'll come to us. You'll get to see Jet catch.
Oh, you don't know where the net is. You don't know where
the net is. The problem with the Snakes is their coach is a player, but he's the head coach of the Eagle Bowl.
Let's give both teams a round of applause. Stingrays are your winner, 34-14.